two of our semi-finals have been completed. Next on court will be the second of the men's singles semi-finals. The European champion Marc Zwiebler of Germany up against Sugiarto of Indonesia. Well, disappointment for Indonesia in the mixed doubles, and disappointment for Indonesia in the first of our semi-finals. The first men's singles will reach away of Malaysia. The four times former champion safely booked his place in tomorrow's final, having defeated Rumbaka. Now, the home fans will be longing for some home success in this next match. Of course, after this men's singles, we'll then have men's doubles. Then we'll have the first of our women's singles with World Championship bronze medalist Schenk of Germany up against the Olympic bronze medalist Simon Awol of India. Then we'll have a repeat of the Olympic final of the mixed doubles, an all-Chinese affair. Then we'll have the second women's singles, and we'll finish off with men's doubles. So there is the left-handed European champion, Marc Zwiebler of Germany. And Tommy Sugiarto. What a tournament he's had forever in his career, having been compared to his father, Ichuk Sugiarto, the former world champion. Now, I hope people will talk about Tommy Sugiarto in his own right. Here he is in his first ever semi-final of a Premier Super Series. He's been in a Super Series semi previously. That was in Hong Kong at the end of last year. But this is his first ever Premier event. For Marc Zwiebler, of course, he was in the semi-final of the All England 2 years ago. So there we can see the men's singles draw. As I was just saying, Lee Chong Wei already booked his place in tomorrow's final, which will be his fifth final here at the Indonesia Open. Great to see two Indian players in the quarterfinal stage of the men's singles, and the two Indonesian players who were in the quarterfinals progressing through to the semi-finals. But here, Tommy Sugiarto, who turned 25 2 weeks ago, born in West Jakarta, number 20 in the world ranking, and his win-loss record for the year translates into reaching the final of the German Grand Prix. In the semi, he had beaten Boonsack Ponsana, but lost in the final of that German event to Chen Long of China, the man that he beat in the very first round here. Of course, Chen Long, the number two seed, the current All England champion. I can tell you, Sugiarto was 14-18 down in that second game, seven straight points to close it out, 21-18 in that second game. Had a tough old battle yesterday against Guru Saidat from India, dropping the opening game. Came back strongly, 21-10 in an hour and 7 minutes in the decider. So to the left-hander, the 29-year-old from Bonn in Germany, up one place in the world ranking this week to number 22. He has been as high as 11. That was in March 2 years ago, and that was because he reached the semi-final of the All England in March. His ranking shot up to number 11 in the world. He spent 1 week at number 11 and has never reached those giddy heights again. At 22 at the moment. But all of his matches so far, as you can see, have been done in very efficient style. All of his matches in two straight games. AJ Djarum in yesterday's quarterfinal, and Djarum had disposed of the number four seed Sonny Lee Conchoro in the round of 16. So this is the fourth meeting between these two men. And as you can see, Marc Zwiebler holds the advantage on the previous three, having won two of them, including the last, which was the first round of the Premier Super Series event, the first Super Series of 2013. Three games on that occasion.
Stop practice, players.
All three meetings went the full distance, went to three games. I think we can expect a right old battle here as we well, he has had the most incredible tournament as Tommy Sugiarto. He looked at the draw when it was released a couple of weeks ago and said, oh heck, got to play the number two, Sing Chen Long, in the first round. I wonder how many people would have put money on him being here still on semi-finals day. Probably not many, but all credit to the man for doing so. He has been brilliant throughout. The European champion, Marc Zwiebler, who won the European title last year in Karlskrona.
Yes, players ready.
When it comes to the semi-final, under the radar, it's not really caused any ripples. What many people have been talking about him. So efficient has been his path through to this stage. Preparations, time, shoelaces. Himself ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Marc Zwiebler, Germany. And on my left, Tommy Sugiarto, Indonesia. Marc Zwiebler to serve, love all, play.
So the European champion, the left-hander Marc Zwiebler from Germany, getting the semi-final underway.
One, love.
The hopes of the nation. Shoulders. These players unseeded, of course, so we'll have an unseeded player. That's the number one seed tomorrow's final.
Service over. One on.
Unseeded. Just shows how much strength and depth there is in this singles discipline.
One. Service over. Two, three.
Singles in the Suleiman Cup campaign. You know, some of the higher ranked players were injured or not available, and he's stepped up to the plate, and he really has grown in confidence, having been given that status and that responsibility. Now he's performing well in the individual tournaments, and it's great to see.
Yeah. It suits him.
Yeah.
You know, he looks like. And he looks like I can do this. So,
three all.
And of course, we've had the opportunity to watch Tommy Sugiarto in both, well, in his second round match against Wong Wing Kee. And we've talked about his qualities. Just quickly remind us. You know what you see as his best aspects of his game.
I think Tommy, you know, he has what he's. I think has been his biggest improvement in this tournament from what I'm seeing.
Three all.
He's play. Very solid. He's playing tactically better than I've seen him do. And then he's really
ball.
Too
great for service over, 4-3.
You know, he's kind of what I would call a really good all-round player. And then again, you can't say it enough. Technically, very, very gifted player.
I tell you what impressed me yesterday.
Service over, 4-all.
He was 19-18 up in the opening day. There was a smash from the Indian player down the line.
Player led.
It was called out by the line. line judge. The umpire, Mike Walker, overruled the line judge. So Thomas Sugiarto probably thought he was going to have game points of 2018, instead of which it was 19-all. He then lost that open game. And what impressed me was
five, four.
He wasn't perturbed by it. He came back so strongly in the second and third games, dropping only 21 points in the next two games. Now that's impressive, because a lot of players, and I think Tommy Sugiarto in the past, would have let that overrun and that line ball effect. Yeah.
Service over, 5-all.
I don't think he's never looked, you know, he's never looked unfit.
Six, five.
I think that's the case with all the Indonesian players, I think, throughout the tournament, and not just the men's singles. I think Indonesia are under the new coaching
staff. Service over. Six, all.
Disciplined, they can look fitter and trimmer, and certainly look more eager as well. It's been impressive.
That's good for badminton.
Yeah.
Service over, 7-6.
Marcus, I would actually say Mark, it kind of suits him playing in this venue, because his game is his attacking game, keeping the attack, as you see here. Lots of variation from the back, holding the net is his strength.
Service over, 7-all.
What can you say? His pressure, when he's putting pressure on his opponents, he's keeping the pressure on us. You can't really get out of it. And then, as we can also see, he doesn't give up. He just keeps going. He's a machine. So, it's a very, I wouldn't say he's.
Service over, 8-7.
Back of the court, he's got a lot of range, which is very solid. So it's very difficult to get in and control the game against him, because he's constantly keeping under pressure.
Many years ago, Marc Zwiebler had to undergo emergency surgery on his back. To this level of balance is quite remarkable in itself, but it's testament to his character.
8-7, just play.
He refuses to give up.
Yeah. And then, of course, I forgot to point out, he's a left-handed. So when you're left-handed, you always have these different angles.
Service over. 8-all.
Left-handed player to come up against. A lot of standard shots from a right-handed player. It's normally to a right-hander's backhand side, which in this case would be Mark's forehand side. So you have to change your game. 108.
Nine, eight.
Left-hander can create different spins on the shuttle to the right-hander, because of course all the feathers in the shuttle always go in to the cork of the feather in the same way, left over right, and therefore when a left-hander slices across the shuttle, it's going against the feathers. Whereas a right hander, it's going with the feathers. So that technically, I never understand in the tennis why everybody says that a left-handed serve should be so effective in the ad court when serving against a right-hander, because there's no difference on the ball. It should be exactly the same for the right-hander serving in the ad court to the left-hander. But there is technically and physically a difference in badminton because of the feathers in the shuttle.
So it's over. 9-10.
Both players are kind of in the middle right now playing this same kind of tactic. A little bit of patience. Not hitting out of all the shots. Trying to wait for that opening.
So it's over. 11-9 into one. Twenty second plus. Eleven nine play. Service solo, 10, 11. All.
But at the same time, you have to give credit to Mark's defense. That was unreal. Then getting back. And then now get back in position. Almost get that one. And you can see, by Mark showing this kind of effort in his defense, Tommy is forced to really play those kind of shots. And it doesn't take more than 2-3 mistakes, then know he's gonna doubt himself. So
11 all play. Service over. 12-11. Service over, 12 all. Service over, 13-12. Service over, 13 all.
It's the spin that's setting him up for the smash. So Mark probably has to see if he can try and play a little bit away from the net. But right now, Tommy is really so good with the net situation.
Thank you. that's close. Service over, 14-13.
Tommy under 30. Pressure. First on the first rally here, he was driving to his body. Second rally here, he was just keeping the pressure on, and that's difficult to get out of.
Service over, 14-15. Service over, 16
all. All four corners of the court.
That's Tommy. Tommy, come on. All play. Play alert.
Oh, that was a good flick serve.
Tommy, fast. Get ready fast.
I didn't think Tommy Sugiarto was settled already.
We've seen people take more time than him. So.
Tommy
Sugiarto towards the umpire. He's pleading for an overrule.
I think he was trying to look for a call for that it touched him, but I don't think it touched him.
That's too small. Well, since the umpire spoke
20,
to
him, game point,
Tommy
16.
Sugiarto has lost five straight points.
Service over. 17-20.
The overrule yesterday. A crucial moment.
The testing.
Yeah. Well, he came through the test yesterday with flying colours.
Game.
Takes the opening game, the German.
First game won by Marc Zwiebler, 21-17.
21-17 confirms the umpire. 8-19 minutes. Oh, enough to battle his opponent, battle the crowd. And final smash. Put away with ease.
Second game, love all, play. Service over, one love. Service over, one all.
God, I don't think that's going to happen today.
No.
It's too clever for that. Just as we didn't notice that we haven't really noticed him in the tournament, we didn't really notice either. That's what I like about him, he's just very solid. Boom, he takes the first set. It was the 15 all or something like that. And then
2-1.
The adventures play you see from Taufik or Li Chengwei or whatever, but it's just very solid and effective.
It's interesting to me that Mark Trader hasn't actually played.
Service over, do all.
Championships. In March, he didn't play the Indian Super Series event. And he didn't play in Germany's Sudden Cup campaign. Now, I don't know whether it's because he was injured or whether he chose to have a training period and get himself ready, whether he felt
Service
too
over.
Much on the
Three,
treadmill of
two.
This tournament after tournament. Do you have any inside information on that?
Nope. I really don't. It must be that I don't think I haven't heard anything about an injury. I don't really remember, but I was the coach of the Danish team. We were down playing some exhibition matches against the Germans. And he was playing there, so...
Service over, three,
maybe
all.
To stay home and prepare, just as you saw the Danish team in Europe, where Jan stayed home to focus in the All England, and of course, as we all know, Tina Baum stayed home, and she ended up winning the All England. So it could have been something else. Or maybe it's something else.
4-3. Quiz.
He's left.
Resigned.
He's not in the German Federation anymore, so it could be something like that. It doesn't look like that. The coach is still down there. So it must have been either an injury that was after I saw him play, or that he chose to focus on.
Service over. 4-4. Five, four. Service over, 6-5.
Somehow the Indonesian has got to take away the attacking play from his opponent. Now I know that's very easy for me to sit here and say that, but is there anything he should be doing different tactically to implement that?
He needs to try and focus on taking the front court away from Mark, and you see, they're not going to work. First of all, he's on the drift side now, so he's not going to be able to control, so we're going to see more of those mistakes now if he continues to do that. So I would, if I was him, I would play more into the court and have some more patience.
7-5,
take the
play.
And then maybe force Mark to try and focus on it. But the problem is he should have done that in the first set, because he would have had the drift against him. But he didn't really use that. Right now, it's just pushing it down to the corners. And
8-5.
Just standing there under pressure, and eventually he will make mistakes like doing that. So he hasn't really been ready for that. So that is not going to work.
9-5.
Five straight points from 5-all. A very different complexion in the second game on this entire match. That's going on.
11-5 interval.
Advantage at the game interval. to Marc Zwiebler's match against another Indian player, PJ Jayaraj, which was 35 points. So one wonders whether perhaps this match is just one match too far.
20 seconds.
Both physically 20 seconds. And emotionally. I mean, the emotion.
Thank you, Butch.
High he would have experienced after beating Chen Long in the first round. So we'll see, of course, Chen Long in the bronze medalist.
Yes, Tommy.
It's a combination, I think you're right. It's both.
Yes, please.
And I also think we have to give credit to Mark. He's up against a little bit more clever player. He's using his advantage.
11-5.
Played way more on the tour than he has. I thought he did the right thing. You can see Mark really was focused on keeping the attack in the first set because he knew
play.
He was on the grip side. But you can see Tommy here, he hasn't really understood that.
That is just
so Tommy's was, I think, was too loose in the first set. Was too not aware of that. That is actually quick, the side quick. He has to win on.
Thank you.
Diving, he's very, very careful not to touch the net. I tell you, it's shots like that sometimes that can really break the spirit of an opponent.
12-5. Service over. 6-12.
You see, another tactic could be just to go all in. I'm going to take the lead and I'm going to attack all the time. He's a little bit like Mark did. And then just accept that's going to be very, very hard.
Service over. 13-6. Service over, 7-15. Service over, 16-7. Service over, 8-16. Nine-16. Service over, 17-9.
He was making mistakes when he was already a game down in the mixed doubles, the previous semi-final that we watched. I'm liking this chap more and more.
He's had a good attitude.
Yes, he has.
There's a lot of things to still work on in this game, but it's a good attitude.
I suspect time is running out for him in this particular match, but...
Ball. Service over. 10-17. Service over, 18-10.
Since the Denmark Open in 2009.
19-10. Match point 10.
I think just being one match too many. He's had a terrific week, but Marc Zwiebler today has been concentrated. He's been very positive in his style and tactically. He's been very sound indeed. 10 match point opportunities.
Game.
And that will do. So disappointing for Indonesia once again. Three semi-finals. And the three Indonesian participants who have to settle for second best today. Marc Zwiebler. Now that's nice to see. Pity really that Marc Zwiebler didn't go and thank his opponent first before speaking to his coaches. But it is a big occasion for him. Their confirmation of the score, 21-17, 21-10 in 36 minutes.
Match won by Marc Zwiebler, 21-17, 21-10. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yes, the final rally. Sugiarto just not expecting the shot across court at all. So it will be German Marc Zwiebler in tomorrow's final against the four-time former champion and current world number one, Lee Chong Wei.